AP graders of Reddit, what are the most greatest ridiculous funny things you have seen on a test you were grading? Not me, but my Comp C teacher was a grader in 2016, and he said he had kids write notes to him saying I can't take the test since my teacher taught me the wrong language but I have to sit for the exam kind of thing. My English teacher told me someone once drew a $100 bill flying through a window on the essay portion. My high school AP English teacher was a grader. He once read an essay that was just the lyrics to La Bamba and that was it. Not a grader, but a note to all you seniors out there taking AP exams, if you strike through anything like this, it can't be graded so you can write whatever you want. You can even put the lyrics to La Bamba in your essay without penalty, so long as it's struck through. My teacher is a grader for AP literature. Apparently once he had an incredibly detailed drawing of a toilet with $100 going down the drain. My AP physics teacher once got a super detailed drawing of a unicorn jumping over a rainbow for the FRQ. As someone who just took the AP Lit test the other day, that's what it feels like. My teacher said that quite a bit of people put money in the packet, but they can't keep the money. That's kinda given how much money the college board extracts from high school students already. For the student it's like hey, I've got this $20, maybe that's worth another point. For the grader, it'd be a nice little tip, given what we pay our educators. Meanwhile college board is like add it to the pile. Pay for grading standardized tests is even worse than our normal pay. Yeah, and this year they wanted me to grade from home, saving money on airfare and hotel, while cutting the pay from last summer. It's one thing to ask me to leave my family for a week and come grade out of town. It's another to ask me to ignore my family 4 hours a day with no time for professional collaboration, etc. for less pay. Passed. My dad used to grade AP government tests. The week of the exams in my class he would show us some of the funnier responses to make us feel better and more confident. I had him for both AP's history as well as government. It has been many years but my favorite response he saw was politics originates from Latin. Poly meaning many and ticks being bloodsuckers. I don't even remember the question the student responded to, but I still remember the response. I think it's funnier if you go with the real Latin meaning of the poly which I believe is city. So the ticks that suck the blood out of the city. I took the AP chemistry exam on Monday, and I had no clue for one of the questions. I just wrote Finland. My AP world teacher grades and once told me that a student just turned in a paper that says I never learned this just fail me, for his DBQ. I took AP world test the year the DBQ was based on cricket. Wild ride. Not a grader. A friend and I took the AP Italian exam a few years back. There was a persuasive essay section. We were given 3 sources that we had to reference in the essay. 2 of the sources were written, and 1 was audio. My friend and I couldn't even understand the prompt, let alone the audio source, but we were able to translate a few words here and there. We both figured out that the prompt had something to do with the birth rates in Italy over the last 20 years. I tried my best to write a good essay, but my friend just wrote an essay about how babies in Italy are aging at a dramatic rate of 1 year per year, and if this trend continued then all the current babies would eventually grow up and we would run out of babies. His proposed solution was to grind some babies down into baby powder and use the baby powder to create new babies. Neither of us passed. I taught English in Thailand for an advanced immersion school. Plagiarism was rampant. One kid turned in an essay on sea slugs that changed mid-paragraph to the Wikipedia entry for the British surface-to-air missile, not the animal. I just about died laughing. Smooth. Not a grader, but I had a friend who was running out of time on the AP Physics C, so for the last question he wrote oh god why in big letters across the page. Still got a 5. Most likely because the curve for AP Physics C tests is like 55% or higher is a 5. Absurdly high curve. Absurdly high curve, but the fail rate is still 60%+, 1S and 2S. To be fair, absurdly high curves are normally because of absurdly hard tests. I know the AP Gov curve this year will basically be non-existent. I was in APUSH around 10 years ago. At the time, I'm not sure if this is still the case or not, You could omit anything from your essay portion by striking one line through it. So a misspelled word or name or whatever could be quickly erased without spending time actually erasing it. Well, around this time, the movie 300 came out. There was sort of this national joke movement to write "This is Sparta" in all caps somewhere in your essay, and then put a line through it. After the summer, we asked our teacher, who was also a grader, if he came across any of these. He said that it was so prevalent that on the last day of grading, whenever someone came across one, they would stand up in the middle of the quiet grading hall and shout out "This is Sparta" before sitting back down and continuing to grade as if nothing had happened. I always got a kick out of that. I was taking an AP environmental science test, and the essay was something about what happens when a large tree dies in a faucet ecosystem. I forget the specifics. My essay started like this: if a tree dies in the forest, and no one is around to hear the sound, it makes as big of an impact on the ecosystem as it does the ground. I then proceeded to answer the question and finished with a shitty drawing of a tree. For some reason, they gave me college credit for that essay. AP Lang teacher here to reassure you that this starter sentence is an excellent example of a strong exordium that demonstrates control of your writing voice at mastery level. Don't dismiss it, celebrate it. Not a grader, but had a friend who took AP Art History with me. On the free response section, he had to analyze a modern piece, and he, being French, instead wrote 4 pages on how modern art is not art. He got a 5 on the exam. Edit, wow. Thanks everyone. I'll tell you another story about him as well. One time in art history class, we were passing around a model of an Egyptian statue and I handed it to him, which he in turn dropped. It broke in half. He insisted thereafter he was a saint as he had destroyed the false idol. Not a grader, but I wonder what the grader thought of my AP World History test. I essentially wrote Ferdinand and Isabella fan fiction about them going on a spring break trip together because I wasn't sure how to answer the question. I was shocked when I got a 3 on the test. Well, I'm not an AP grader, but I scored a 5 by regurgitating some random shit about First Nations people that I had heard on Reddit the day before. Thanks guys. If you're gonna bullshit on an exam, then you gotta sell that bullshit. I've heard of kids writing extremely detailed, well-written essays based on pure bullshit and getting a good grade on it. My APUSH teacher said one of the best he'd seen was "I have no idea what's going on, but the teacher was a MILF so it was worth it." No idea if it's true though. My AP environmental science teacher was a grader and showed us pictures of a girl writing all about her breakup with her boyfriend for 6 pages instead of fish and trees and shit. Truly a magnificent emotional appeal, did not deserve a 1. During our AP US history test, the question was something like, "How did the Great Awakening lead to the settlement of many towns by person?" I don't know exactly what it was. My friend's answer went something like, "The Great Awakening rose Person and his crew from a deep slumber and they decided to found the towns of old." Meanwhile, I wrote the entire lyrics to "Rap God." Drawing of a dragon was my personal favorite instead of answering the question. They were a good artist, but that was it. I had a student that didn't really understand a certain part of the chemistry we learned for that test. Kid was an absolute genius, but he just couldn't wrap his head around this specific area of chemistry. When he got to that area on the test, he wrote an incredibly detailed explanation on why pi 3.14 was the answer to every question on the test. He went on to say that pi is infinite and thus has every possible combination of numbers in every sequence that they could ever possibly exist. His point behind this was to say that if each number was equated to letter, 1 being the letter A and 26 being the letter Z, somewhere inside of pi contained all the answers to the questions that were asked on the test in the order that they were written. Since pi does technically go on forever, he was technically correct. I gave him half credit for it. Not a grader, but since single line crossouts are supposed to be ignored by graders, every single student in my APUSH class wrote "Bush did 9/11 and crossed it out mid-sentence at some point in our essays." My AP teacher told us about a student who wrote a 5-page paper about prom. What he wore, who he brought, and basically everything they did that night. And at the end he wrote 1 sentence giving the correct answer. The graders are obligated to read the whole paper, and they had to give him full credit. Thanks for watching. Now here is a picture of Thanos as a fish.